Nayaka seems like a high school girl. She's irrational and crazy, and she just seems like she's on her period all the time. Rain is not that big of a deal here. We're on a beach. We're wet anyway. I mean, who cares? But I'm actually, like, relishing in it. You know, just keep checking out. Like, it's better for me if you want to go home, because that's just one less person I have to battle against.
The homosexual, he's one of the nicest guys I ever met, and he's good at what he does. You know, he's got leadership ability, and if these people here would listen to him, he would take them a long way. But anyway, me and Richard got to be pretty good friends. Not in a homosexual way, that's for sure.
Make sure you get this on
TV.
Oh,
boy, you better have there a beer go. In your hand when you're doing this one, Ash,
Rudy. Pretty good guy. I don't know what my buddies are going to say when I get home, but I'll have to deal with that.
It's going to be me and John in the final two. I mean, John, yeah, he's a snake. He lies, but he also tells the truth, too, and I know he's not sitting here lying to me about going to the final two.
Todd was going for the Oscar with his performance of my sister had a convenient miscarriage. And then, of course, Jeff was like, Todd, it looks like you just got some bad news. What happened? And Todd's like, my sister, she was pregnant and she lost the baby, but it happened for a reason. Like, that is not like the fake Johnny Fairplay, my grandma died. You can almost forgive that. That's funny.
Roger, Butch, and Dave think that they have this game sewn up. Sorry, there was an Adam and then there was an Eve. And you remember, Eve just kind of took Adam right along with the rest of the boat. And that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna play them, we're gonna play them hard because we're gonna beat them at their own game. You can't be cocky and just assume that girls are gonna lie down and let it all happen. And gosh, thanks, that was so good. You guys are such good players, congratulations. No, game is mine. Roger is gone, then Dave, and then the rest will have to work itself out. And they can sit there and they can be cocky, but I'm gonna tell you, some boys are gonna be sweating tomorrow night after Roger goes home.
Helen, everything's serious, serious. I mean, there's no play to her. She's supposed to be some kind of marine expert. She's kind of got the personality of an encyclopedia. You open it up, there ain't nothing in there fun to read. You only open it when you need information.
That challenge was a nightmare, and we ended up losing. But it didn't dawn on me until just now that Spencer and Shireen had their fate in their own hands, and they lost it. Now, one of those two is going home tonight. How poetic.
You're offering 7 starving adults a piece of candy out of your mouth. Keep your mint candy, man. You know, that's like saying, anybody wanted this piece of doodoo?
Screw John, because he's an ass. Everything that comes out of his mouth is just ridiculous.
Her days are numbered. We have bigger threats to get rid of first, but she's not one of the final four. So, and I got a mill that says she won't be the final one.
Reward was for a horseback ride and breakfast, and you get to milk your own milk, I guess. I don't know if that makes sense. You get to milk your own milk, and that sounds amazing. We should have won, and we should be going, because that is amazing.
It was hard to see Rachel at Redemption. I knew she was going to be there. It was the only move for them that made sense, really, if they wanted to try and win challenges. So now I have to get all the way to the end, or I would regret not stepping in for Rachel.
I thought you made the right decision, to be honest with you.
When she lost and I got to hug her, I asked her if she had fun. And she said she did, and for me that was enough. Because it is a game, you know? Too many people take it too serious, and it shouldn't be. And it ruins their lives and it makes them angry. And a good example of that is Colin.
Holly keeps getting stranger and stranger. And every time she speaks, it becomes more evident that she's crazy. So I'm gonna keep one eye on her and one eye on my shoes.
In my perspective of beauty, there is hot and there's cute. Morgan, she's hot, whereas the other girls are like cute. And me personally, I trust cute more than I trust hot.
I'm trying to reason with Cochran a little bit and trying to get him to take me. Because if I do win the $1 million prize, I want to open like a dog kind of like shelter, kennel, playpen area, like attached to a bar. So like those are my two favorite things. I like dogs and I like bars. So if I could open a bar and like you just bring your dog there, that'd be unbelievable.
The first board that a mimic idol could have been was a blank board. Well, apparently it's missing because I didn't see it. I know an animal didn't come and pick it up and take it away, so one of them picked it up and think it's the idol.
Are those ones filled? Do they need some more water?
I'll bring it over and let's see.
I figured Jamie would have been looking for it, but there's no way this dummy grabbed the wrong one because it would have to say immunity something on it. The thought of this woman having a blank one, I would not be able to take it. I would pass out in pure joy. My head would explode. Please let that happen. Please. That would be the best thing ever. That would be the best one ever. You pull out a blank thing. And it was like, what you mean? But they don't have no writing on there. You just have to have something. Why do I want a D?
Russell won immunity, so essentially I have to do whatever Russell says because he's wearing the idol. I'm feeling wonderful because regardless, Russell's keeping me around because I'll never get a single vote. But I don't know about that.
The good news is, you'll never believe it. There's fish in the ocean. You know, I feel sorry for her in one sense because she's kind of desperate right now trying to catch fish. And then on top of not catching the fish, she loses our stuff. You just signed your own death warrant is basically what you did.
So to solidify that he is trustworthy, Tony exposed that he lied. Different.
See, when I first came here, I was gonna say I have a son too, and I was gonna swear my son all day long.
You know, I didn't peg him as a smart guy. I mean, he has a lot on his mind, and he's not a dummy by any means. And I realized by him exposing all that stuff that I do need to be on my toes every single point in the game.
When I did it the first time in the Outback, it was all about the adventure. It wasn't about the strategy at all. I haven't played Survivor in 15 years. Is this the way you do it now?
I'm so out of my element right now, you guys. I feel like I don't know what to do, like I don't know where to turn.
I don't know if it's 15 years of waiting for this opportunity, and here it is. But it's coming at the right time for me. I'll be 50 next year. That's a big year. And most men my age go through a midlife crisis. They buy a Corvette, they cheat on their wives. I go on Survivor. It's not about a midlife crisis, it's about a midlife quest. And the second half of my life begins with Survivor Second Chance.
So I sit down with Cass and she's like, we're voting for Spencer.
Dude.
I'm like, all right, good. But Spencer's still making moves. Being tired, being hungry, being thirsty. I don't recall what happens if it's a tie in the final four. How's that work? I know I won't be able to vote. Spencer won't be able to vote. Then if it goes to another tie, then man, we're gonna have to draw rocks? The jury? We fight for it? I don't know. What happens? Is the first one to be able to make a fire? Anything can happen in tribal council.
You know how people say they have a gaydar? Well, I have like a cop dar. Like, I could tell who cops are, and Tony's a cop. And I knew it from day one, and he finally told me. I felt like I won the lottery. I was like, gosh, dang it, I knew I was right.
God, oh my God, I was in so much shock. We all didn't say anything after that. He is a loose cannon, and there's a lot of tension between Brandon and Michaela. In his biblical terms, he'd probably call her like the whore of Babylon. I think Brandon right now is just really torn between following whatever crazy religious beliefs he has, and yet, at the same time, he, like, inherently in his bloodline, is a devious jerk.
You know, at the reward challenge, Jeremy's like, man, you gotta, just gotta have confidence. You know, you need to believe in yourself. And you know what? Like, I'm putting everything into winning Survivor. That doesn't manifest itself in challenges. I know that I'm not good at those.
The bargain. Just think about it.
Just let it percolate. I'm good at other things. You know, in terms of the strategic moves, that to me is what this game is about. It's about the social strategy. It's about building alliances and maintaining alliances and targeting the right person at the right time.
He's like trying to get us out to save Wentworth. So he's not by on strong.
Right. It would be unexpected.
But you think it's a mistake because it's too much too soon.
Yeah.
If I can't get my alliance to make that move with me, I have failed. You know, like you don't get a lot of shots at taking out your major competition. And, you know, what actually works me up is, oh my God, I can't believe I'm getting teary. It's the idea that, like, you know, I would miss this. Oh my God, this is so silly. That I would miss the second chance. I would miss my. You know, I put so much into it last time, but I still came up short. And I'm putting so much into it this time. And the idea that I would come up short because I just couldn't get my crew to take the shot that we needed to take. Like, I've been kicking myself, you know, for so many years just for not getting rid of the golden boy last time. But to just wait for the game to come to you and pass you by, like, that would be a real loss for me, to not take control of the game when we have the chance. God, it would be such a great move. It would be such a great move. This would be the move that set the tenor for the whole season.
Mike thanked God for making him the leader of the tribe. I don't know when he was anointed, but apparently my back was turned at that moment.
Yes, I feel like I'm being evil right now, but boy, does it feel good. Colby's gone. I mean, what more can I say? I've now officially lived out one of my goals in this game, and that is to make it longer than Colby. Knock, knock. You hear that sound, Colby? That's the bellboy, and he just took all my baggage away. So, my closet is now cleaned. My survivor closet is clean.
So, I have a clue to where the idol is heading, and until my torch is snuffed, I will be trying to find that idol, because there's no question about it, I'm probably gonna need it. The clue reads something like, and I love this word, somewhere near your beach. It's right beneath your nose. The real frustrating part is I have a feeling that I've been like past this thing like 100 million times. It's like right there. And then everybody's gonna see, there's gonna be like this flash on the screen, and they're gonna be like, this dummy, he's walking past it, and it just sucks.
Trying to have fun and be all business. And then Savage bringing up that story with his wife, yeah, it touches you, you know? Makes you think. My wife is pregnant, and I just wanna see her stomach, you know what I mean? I wanna be there to see it grow.
I'm not telling anybody.
I got so much riding on me anyways. I know they're gonna come after me as a physical threat.
And you're gonna add on that my wife is pregnant. No one's gonna wanna take me to the end.
But I gotta control this a little bit. Val knows how much this means to me and to her, you know? She's the reason why I'm doing this again, you know?
I said that the only way Roger is gonna win immunity is if it's a contest named that Perry Como song, or perhaps what type of prune is this, or some sort of other thing that only an old man like Roger would be able to determine.
Is anybody left in this game willing to play with me? Because I don't think so. And that's a sad realization. Like, is that something about me and about my personality? I mean, what do I have to change? It's really hard for me because I constantly find myself in this game in a position that's analogous to where I grew up. I grew up in a rich Orange County suburb where the majority of my classmates were beautiful and skinny, and I stood out for not being any of those things. And I constantly felt like I was fighting for people to like me, and like I was fighting for people to see the good qualities in me. And I think there's probably a lot of this scenario tapping into that. But I'm trying to do now what I was incapable of doing back then, which is deal with it, adapt, fix it.